Hi, I'm Daryl with 6 Mile Leather. Today we're going to be making a cast iron skillet handle cover. Making it out of Hermann Oak. I believe it is 5/6 ounce leather. Traced off the pattern, and then I'll be cutting it out.
Empty promises I've given. Hollow. Beats in my chest, and every word of sterling silver stirs butterflies beneath your breath.
Going to clean up the edges with a rotary tool with a sander on it. Just kind of clean them up and make them look a little bit smoother. Use my wing dividers and make a border for stamping.
Now, honey, still coming up like a rose, dead still in the garden, waiting for the rest.
I'll tape the back with packing tape so when I wet it and start to stamp it, it will not stretch the leather out too bad.
If it's ever gonna set on me. Hear the song she sang in darkness, cheerful, fair, and free and fine. You're the one.
Here I'll wet the leather down and get it ready for stamping. I get it good and wet with a spray bottle. Let it sit for a few minutes to let the water soak up. Putting my maker's mark on the back of the handle cover. And a Made in Texas stamp. I'll use my swivel knife to cut the border so it has a good clean line. I'm gonna mark my lines. I'm gonna do a hand cut basket weave pattern. I'm using a popsicle stick to get my distance for my lines.
Told me fade, but we'll come collect. Hard-tempered steel bites at my ankles. Soft cotton roll burns at my neck.
Go one direction and turn it over and go the other direction to get my blocks for my tooling.
Making a checkerboard pattern. Couldn't figure out what I was trying to say.
I'll use my swivel knife to cut those lines that I just scribed in. Going to bevel the alternate blocks, alternating between every other one, going one direction and then turn around and go the other direction for the other side to give it the basket weave effect.
People stop and step aside so I can move along. Is it just because they're friendly or the fact that I am gone? Stepping over lines of the paths they travel on.
living on the hot side. Better keep it on the low down. Get the feeling just right. Think I'll have to go and sit down.
Well, as usual, I see where I messed up, but we call it character, not a flaw. It's character. Make a couple of decorative cuts with my swivel knife on each block just to give it some definition.
Swivel like a preacher in the presence of the Lord, shaking like a leaf in the middle of a storm, jawing my bone, trying to make you see. I wouldn't much fret if my friends were all here, but there's people in the corner and they're starting to stare.
Using ProResist to keep the antique die from dyeing the entire piece of leather, instead of just getting into the decorative cuts and in the cuts to make it pop. Using Fibbings antique paste, this is mahogany. It'll give it just a little bit of a reddish tint, but not bad. Looks pretty good. Once covered with the antique paste, we'll wipe it off after just a couple of seconds or so, and get it off the top, and hopefully it stays in the cuts.
Hey, Mr. Bartender.
After the paste dries, I'll hit it with a tan coat for a sealer. That way that dye doesn't come off on people's hands that use it.
Tomorrow morning, Sunday, I'm gonna be feeling low. So please,
got the back piece, drew lines on it to where I can know where it's gonna fit, where the top is gonna fit on there, and then where the glue needs to go to. That's why there's two lines on there. Using contact cement for the glue to get it down. Once I get a contact cement on both pieces, let it set for a few minutes, let it get it tacky, and then put it together and hammer it down.
Mr. Bartender, please don't be so slow. I got time for one more round and a six-pack to go. Tomorrow morning, Sunday. gonna be feeling low. So please, please, bartender, I want a six.
Once hammered down, it's all stuck together good. I'll do a little trim work around it. I leave a little extra on the back just so it can be trimmed. Make it easier, just where you don't have to line up exactly right if they're both the exact same size. It's best to leave a little feather on the edge to trim it up.
I got time for one more round and a six pack to go. One six pack to go.
I'll use a rotary tool with a sander drum on it to clean up the edges, get them all nice and pretty, even. Put in a stitch groove all the way around it to where I can run my stitches so they kind of sit down into the leather a little bit. Using a 6mm pricking iron to get the stitch holes in the leather.
5 years old with a smile on my face. Mama's in the kitchen, daddy's playing bass downtown. Downtown. Dad walks in, says, "Sherry, my girl, we need to talk. Remember that night with John Boy? Well, you know I saw it all and I was scared. Oh, for the first time.
Two needles to do a saddle stitch. I'm not going to use my stitching pony. I'm just going to hold it by hand and get it stitched up for you.
To the next town. Oh, my friends, we were gone. Just like that.
Don't want to bore you with watching me saddle stitch this whole thing. So, magic of video, we're done. I'm gonna burn the edges, the ends of the thread, to get them sinked down in and keep it from fraying. And then hammer down the stitches to get them set in. Using a number 3 edge beveler, we'll bevel the front and the back. And then I'll slick them up, make them look pretty before I dye them. We'll hit the edges with a little bit of water, and then I'll use a hard bar of saddle soap to put a little bit of saddle soap on the edge of it. Then I'll use a canvas cloth to burnish the edges and make them look like one. Go ahead and put a little tocanol on the edges just to give it a little bit better look to the edge.
Once I had me a woman, everything was going my way.
I'm going to use a wood slicker to give it a little bit more of a burnish on the edge, make it look a little bit better.
There was a long bed forward in
my spot that I damn sure didn't own. I walked up to the screen door and I heard this awful noise. I moved on to the living room and there sat my two boys. I said, "Where's Mama?" And they both pointed to the bedroom down the hall. And I ain't never been a fighting man, but red was all I saw. See, brother, 'cause I've been down and I've been out and I know how it
feels. When you're fibbing, it's dark brown. Dye on the edges, and I'll give it several coats just to make it look really good.
Means I'll ride here in this cell for eternity. Well then, mister, I'm as guilty as can be. Well, I wish I had me a picture of what his face looked like. Kicked in my bedroom door and raised my 45. I said, "I ain't the kind to hurt a woman, and I hope you understand. Somebody's got to die today, son. It looks like you're the man." See, brother, 'cause I've been down and I've been out, and I know how it feels to stand up for what you think is right and get knocked off your heels.
And that's the completed project. Go find a cast iron skillet to test it out on, make sure it's going to be okay. Need to run a bone folder in it to be able to get the glue off of the stitches so it'll fit a little bit better.
And I knew there'd be hell to pay if I fulfilled my grudge. See, I don't mind these prison bars tucked off in these pine trees.
Well, that's it. Works perfect. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and leave a comment. Let me know how I'm doing. Thank you.